Hi guys, welcome to Python tutorial. In this session, we are going to learn looping statements in Python. Python supports two types of the looping statements, for loop and while loop. And also we are going to see the concept of break and continue with an example. Let us go ahead and start. I am going to explain this concept using the Eclipse IDE. So first let us see for loop. In order to demonstrate the for loop, we need the group of elements. So I am going to create a list with the set of integer values. Now I have created a list which holds the integer values. And now what we can do is we can iterate through this list using the for. So for I in list 1, and then you can print I. Now what for loop is going to do is, for loop will look for this list 1 and identify how many elements are there, and each time it is going to iterate through the one element, it is going to print it. Let us go ahead and run this program, and we can see that 1, 2, 5 it has printed, 1, 2, 3, 4, 45, 5 it has printed. And then the next usage of for loop, is, now I am going to create a one more list, list 2 equal to Python Java and Spring. Now another way how we can use for with the we can use for with else condition. How we can do is for language in list 2 print language. Now let us see this output here once again. Now first time we have taken the collection of integers, second time we have taken the collection of string objects. Now another way how you can use for with the else loop is, here I am going to give the input language equal to C. Okay, now I want to see whether this particular language is available in this list or not. If it is not available, then what we can do is else printf provided language is not available in the list 2. Now let us go ahead and print this one. Okay, now let us go ahead and run this program now. If you see here, Python, Java, Spring and provided language is not available in the list. So whenever if we provide any, if you want to verify whether particular object is available as part of this list or not, if it is not available, then else condition is going to be executed. And the next one, how you can use the for loop is, using the range function. So for I in range 1 to 10, let us consider, and then print I. Okay, just we will print out one print statement to differentiate the outputs. Here for loop with range function. Okay, so now let us go ahead and run this program. If you see here, 1 to 9 it has printed. For example, this is the lower boundary and this is the upper boundary. If you don't provide any lower boundary, then what happens is it is going to start from the 0. Now let us see range function without lower boundary. Now if I remove this lower boundary of 1, then what happens is it is going to start from the 0 till 9, it is going to print. Now let me run this program again. We can see the output 0 to 9. And the second one is, if you observe the output, you can see that it is incrementing by 1. For example, I want to increment by my own way, like plus 2 or plus 3, I can increment for the each iteration. Then it has support for that, range function has a support. So in order to do that, first we need to provide the lower boundary, and then the next parameter is going to take the increment value, whether it should increment by 2 or it should increment by 3, you can specify here. And this range function, I can say range function with increment by 2. Okay, now let us go ahead and run this program. And you can see here now 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So it has incremented by 2 in a ascending order. For example, you want to print from the descending, that means highest value to lowest value, then you can, the for with the range range function is also has the support for that. Here you need to specify the max value until what is the range, and then you can specify the negative number. Then what happens is it is going to start from the 10 until it is going to come with the 0. So here we can say decrement. Okay, now let us go ahead and run this program and see. Here see 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. So these are the different ways you can implement the for loop. Now next we are going to look at how we can write program using the while loop. So while loop, the first thing is you need to take the input based on what range you need to print it. For example, here I am giving count equal to 0, and while count is less than 10, you can print the value of count, and then I can increment this value, count equal to count plus 1. Okay, now let us go ahead and print. Before printing, let us put the print statement so that we can see the difference for this while loop. While loop, and let me remove this one, and let us go ahead and run this program again. If you see here, while loop, it has printed 0 to 9. For example, if you want to increment by 2, then here we can directly change this value. And again, if you run this program, you can see that 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. And similarly, if you want to print from the descending order of it, then initially let it be 10, and then it should print till greater than 0, and let it count should be printed, and then we can specify the count minus 1. Now if I run this program again, this time you see 10 to 1 it has printed. So this is how basically we need to work with the while and for loops. Now let us see the importance of the break and continue. Okay, so now let us consider for I in range of 1 to 10. And then previously we have seen whenever we provide the range, each time it is going to print the from starting 1 to till 9 it is going to print. Now this time my requirement is, if I equal to 5, then I want to exit from the loop, then what we need to do is break and then print I. Okay, let us go ahead and run. and make sure that whenever we write a condition statement, we need to put the colon. And when I run this program, you can see that it started from 1 to 4. So let me print the statement here. Print break keyword example. Okay. Now let us go ahead and run this program once again. Then you can see 1 to 4. So in order to break the loop based on the certain conditions, we use the break keyword. And if we want to continue the particular particular condition, you want to skip that iteration, then use the continue. Now if I run this same program again, you can see here 1 to 9 it came, but 5 is not printed, because by using the continue, what you can do is you can skip the that particular iteration, and others it will keep on continuing. So this is the how you need to work with the looping statements, and in order to break the loop, you need to use the break keyword. And if you want to skip the particular iteration based on the certain condition, then we need to use the continue. Hope you clear with the concept of looping statement, and thanks for watching. Have a nice day.